Hello children, now in this video we will discuss about the history of measurement of time. Have you ever given a thought that how time was being measured when there was no clock, there were no mobiles, there was no such system to measure that time? Now we will discuss some of the history of this measurement of time. Now previously people were depending on the time interval between sunrise and sunset, the time from one season to the other. They were depending on the one full moon to the other. Now these are the certain factors based on which they were measuring time. But these were also discarded. Why? Why they discarded this one? Because these time interval were very large, means very long. Like you see sunrise and sunset, it becomes almost 12 hours, isn't it? Similarly, one season, just imagine, you know, that becomes 4 months to 6 months. Now, out of these, there were these, as well as these also vary from place to place. For example, in summer season, there will be a different length of duration of sunrise and sunset compared to winter. For here, Odisha, there will be a time of sunrise and sunset. In case of Mumbai, there will be another time for sunrise and sunset. There is a little bit difference also in India, in different states. So, based on that, there was no common time for throughout the world. That's why it was gradually discarded. Now, after this, they discovered, people discovered, like some of the watches or clocks, you can say, you know, based on these principles, like sundial was there, sand clock was there, water clock. And after the discovery by Hujin in 1958, there was based on the principle of pendulum. How? He suggested that the time taken by a pendulum to swing from one end to the another is always constant. So that's why, based on that, he devised a clock which was known as pendulum clock. Now after this, in modern clocks and watches, they were quartz crystals. They were made up of quartz crystals, and so many transformations were there. Now, SI unit of time is always measured in second, that all of you know very well. And modern days, there were also some of the processes by which we can measure the very accurate, that is 1/10 of a second, that is measured by stopwatch. You might have observed during the playtime or sports day, Lalat sir or your game teachers, they were having certain processes by which they can measure the time taken by you to cover up the distance. So they are using the stopwatch. You have seen, we can stop it and we can start it according to our own will. Now, these timekeeping services in India are provided by National Physical Laboratory present in New Delhi. And what is the most accurate clock where it is found? It is found in National Institute of Standard and Technology based in USA. Now, let us go back to see the structures of the clock. Now, I can show you closely that these are the clocks. Now, first one, you can see here the sundial, which is based on the length of the shadow during the daytime. The whole day it will just cast the shadow, and length of that shadow, because you know the length of the shadow varies from throughout the daytime, morning and afternoon they will be longer compared to noon. So there will be you will find this sand clock. Now this is the sand and water clock. These both are based on the same principle. Like the fixed amount of sand is passing in the fixed interval of time. That means from one container to the other, one container to the other. Fixed amount of sand is sand or water. In water clock, it is water. They will be coming or passing through this orifice or the hole to the second container. So based on that, they usually measure the time. And this is Huygens pendulum clock. You can see it here. It is based on pendulum oscillation mode or oscillatory mode.